इन दोनों लोगों की आदत को देखते हुए जी नहीं करता टेबल दोनों के दोनों
National Film Festival of India. Today in film industry, trends and innovative techniques are creating a distinctive look, sound and feel for today's art. Pushed forward by rapidly developing technologies, these trends are also changing the ways we think about filmmaking. This session talks about how these directors adapted to these trends and succeeded in the film industry. A great director gives life to work of art, gives it a heartbeat, a pulse, opens his eyes to the world. Today, we have with us such great directors sharing their knowledge and experience. We have with us today an eminent film director from Bollywood. His films are launchpad for several actors in Bollywood. He is a part of the steering committee of the historic Golden Jubilee edition of IFFI and has been the chairman of National Film Awards Jury 2018. Please welcome Mr. Rahul Rawail. We also have one of the best directors in Bollywood today. His films are simple yet elegant. He creates his stories from the fragments of real life. His films touch hearts. He speaks his innermost thoughts and feelings through films. Please welcome Filmfare Award-winning director Mr. Imtiaz. To take this session forward, we have a leading anchor, poet, chat show host and a theatre actor. Please welcome our moderator for the session, Ms. Atika Faruqi. Now I would request Mr. Amit Satija, CEO, Entertainment Society of Goa, and Mr. Ankur Lahoti, Assistant Director, Directorate of Film Festival, to please present mementos to our esteemed guests.
Thank you.
Now hand over the mic to our moderator. Thank you.
So there is a little twist, I'll tell you what. Life is basically cinema with all the boring things edited out. You agree with this? Faiz Ahmed Faiz ka ek sher tha, wo log bahut khushkismat the jo ishq ko kaam samajhte the ya kaam se aashiqui karte the. हम जीते जी मसरूफ रहे कुछ इश्क किया कुछ काम किया. आज के दो शख्सियतें सिनेमा जगत की हमारे साथ हैं. उन्होंने अपने अपने दौर में अपने अपने करियर के शुरुआती दौर में अपनी अपनी फिल्मों के साथ हमें नए तरीके से इश्क करना सिखाया. वो फिल्म लाइक बेताब, लव स्टोरी और इम्तियाज जी का तो पूरा करियर आप जानते ही हैं. उनकी फिल्म में थोड़ा इश्क, थोड़ा मुश्क, थोड़ी रंजिश, थोड़ा इंकलाबी तेवर, थोड़ी बेताबी, प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द यूथ, सब कुछ एक मिक्सचर देखा गया है, राइट? आज हम इन सबको एक्सप्लोर करेंगे, लेकिन इम्तियाज जी के अंदर का जर्नलिस्ट आज जाग गया है और वो कुछ बातें उनसे ऐसी करना चाहते हैं जिसमें शायद दूसरे की जरूरत नहीं है. सो फर्स्ट दे विल हैव अ कन्वर्सेशन विद इन देमसेल्व्स एंड देन आई विल जॉइन देम फॉर अ कन्वर्सेशन.
Thank you very much, Atika.
Here.
the moral of the story is that we often have interviews in which the same questions are asked again and again, and we have the same answers, and we start to think that our life is really boring. A very interesting avenue presented itself, sir, when you called me up and said, why don't you come as a guest to IFFI? And I must share the story here, that I said to him that I'll definitely come since you've called, but my request is that let me interview you. So this is a dream come true for me. I come from a smaller town than most of you, I think, where it was impossible, especially during those times, to even imagine what the film industry would be. And I came into the film industry in early 2000s. My first film was released in 2005. And then I found this to be a place of dreamers and drifters and losers like myself. And I fit right in.
I wish there were more losers like you.
But I think, as far as cinema is concerned, the more important millennium in my life was the previous one, before I became a filmmaker, when I was watching films. At that point of time, when I had no idea how films are made, I was getting influenced by cinema in a very drastic way. And I think that who I am and what my cinema is, in many ways, just a reflection of the influences of my youth. One of the big influences of my youth have been a few films that have been made by this gentleman on the right. And I would like, in this time where I think film industry tends to be very myopic, you know, we move across directors very soon, you know. Atika mentioned a poem by Fez. And I'll mention a poem by Billy Joel, which says that I am the entertainer and I know just where I stand. Another serenader, another long-haired band. Today I am the champion. Today I am the champion. I may have won your hearts, but I know the game. You'll forget my name and I won't be here in another year if I don't stay on the charts. Sometimes to bring value to our own cinema, we have to look back at what has influenced us to become filmmakers. And in this respect, I would like to throw light on two films of yours. There are so many films, there are so many questions I have, but I thought it would be an idea to focus on two of them, sir. Arjun and Dekhet. But before we start talking, let me ask you, how was your childhood? What was Rahul Rawail the kid?
A person who did not want to become a filmmaker.
How come but your father was a filmmaker?
Yeah, my dad was a filmmaker, but I was not keen. I wanted to become, please don't laugh, a nuclear physicist.
Neurophysicist? Yeah. Nuclear physicist.
That's my dream. And Rishi was a chicken. The childhood friend. Okay. And they were starting shooting the circus portion of Imtiaz. So he called me and said, your exams are over. I was 15 years old. So come, let's go watch the shooting. The Russians are here. So I said, what are you doing shooting? He said, look, they're all Russian females. Unhone chote chote kapde pehne honge. It'll be great to come and watch them. So that was the intention of going to watch that shooting, to see women in skimpy little clothes.
So that was the promise of cinema.
That is the promise of cinema. But I went there and I saw Raj Kapoor working for the first time. And that one day, you know, changed my entire outlook. And watching him work and then going over and over again, I decided to become a filmmaker if I could. So that's where the film went from.
But you are pretty much a Bombay boy, sir. You was born and brought up in Bombay.
Absolutely.
I remember I think Betab was released in 1985.
Betab was 84.
Yes, Arjun was.
Betab was 83, sorry.
Right, I have it written over here.
Arjun was 85.
Arjun was 85, right. So I remember that I was in school those days, and some of my friends in school, we were staying over at my house, and those days we used to hire a VCR. And we got many films to watch. I can't name all of them. But one of the movies was Arjun. We watched Arjun at 1 o'clock at night. It got over at 4. We started it again when it got over. And 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the morning, we had seen it 2 times. We literally came out on the street trying to pick a fight with everybody. We maarte hain kisi ko sara. And I'll tell you, I'd seen many films before that. I had no idea what Bombay was, what is the true life in Bombay, what does a young person feel. And I'd like to play a clip for you guys to have a taste of that. And then I can ask some more questions from yourself.
The first one that I do.
This film was made in 1985.
ये लाइट ऑफ हो गए? ये दो लाइट ऑफ हो सकते हैं? Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Arjun! तुम लोग यहाँ क्या कर रहे हो?
तेरे लिए बैठे हैं यार।
तू यहाँ मत घूम, घर जा।
क्यों? क्या बात है?
अरे बहुत बड़ा लफड़ा हो गया। वो रंगा के आदमी तुझे ढूंढ रहे हैं। तीन चार बार टैक्सी में भी चक्कर मार के गए। थोड़ी थोड़ी देर बाद काका की दुकान पे आते तेरे लिए पूछने के लिए।
एक काम कर अर्जुन, तू घर चला जा वरना लफड़ा हो जाएगा।
मैं काका की दुकान पर जाके बैठता हूँ, देखो तो मुझे कौन ढूंढ रहा है।
अर्जुन मेरी बात सुन, अर्जुन तू घर जा, रंगा के छोर पे ढूंढ रहे हैं।
मैं जानता हूँ काका।
अरे क्या कर रहा है? तू क्या करने वाला भाई?
मैं लोगों का इंतजार करूंगा काका।
अब हंगामा हो ही रहा है तो हम सब तेरे साथ हैं। जो होगा देखा जाएगा।
I want to narrate something to you. When in his room, he had this habit of writing on scraps of paper. You know, you find a scrap here, in his pocket, or you find on toilet paper written somewhere. And from about 3:30 till 6:30, he narrated the entire script of Jundubi, which was an absolute achievement. In 3 hours, a man had written an entire script. And then we went to it, and what fascinated me was that this was a chance to exploit Bombay, like you've never seen before. That was what he wanted to do. Arjun had no great story, it was not character driven. So the visuals, this was all a set.
Really?
Yeah, this was all a set.
And then cars are going.
They were all hired.
That's incredible. You know, who made this set?
We had an art director called the gentleman is not with us anymore. The whole thing, the BSC buses and the cars and all.
They were all in the studio.
They were all hired and they were in the studio. So, you know, my bus would come and go whenever I wanted it to go. We didn't have to wait for the timings. In fact, a very funny thing happened was my producers thought that this man is wasting too much money on getting a bus standing every day. And he uses it only at times. So they said, you know, we made arrangements. We get a bus, you tell us when you want it to be there in 2 minutes. I said, fine, we have to find that easy. And we need a bus. I said, I want a bus now. And we had to wait for 2.5 hours because they couldn't find a bus. So that's how we created the character, and the streets were all, you know, the shops, everything was.
But for you to have a grasp on how it is to live in that child, jungle, you know, and the terrace, your lifestyle, I'm sure, was different from that, like from the Malwankar family. But how did you get the insight that they live like this or their relationships are like this?
There was a lot of traveling I used to do by the local trains. You know, that was my means of transport. And at times one would go into Parel, which is where it's supposed to be based.
Incidentally, I lived there when I came into Bombay.
Okay, so you must be knowing more about what Parel was. And that's how the idea just came about. And we tried to create an atmosphere where even a camel was, you would see camels walking on the streets in Bombay. So we had a camel brought in. It took 2 days to reach the project. We had to walk, and my producers always complained, we paid so much money for the camel and we could see it only one shot. I said, no, there.
But in the next film that I'm going to show, there are going to be many camels. So let's have a look at that clip. That's from the kids.
Okay. So.
It's not, this show me having a.
So the producer of Arjun will be very happy to see this clip. This is just for him. more camels than we had ever seen before.
If you only show more sequences from your films, you will have very shortly see an old man crying. So I think we should just talk to that.
Do you remember about Dakhayat, sir?
Dakhayat, to me, is a film which was probably my best work. There's no doubt about that. And getting into the Ramayans.
Yeah, I always wanted to ask you that. That you had no connection with Chambai or with Green Morena, etc. How did you connect so nicely with it?
See, when the script was done, there were sequences which had to be done in the Ramayans.
But first, how did the script even come about? And how were you interested in that story?
Something between John and me and worked out together. You know, when we didn't want the dacoit to be with a pagadi and a tika or what it seemed. Right. And we wanted to see if we know what the dacoits really are. Hmm. So we went across, Javed, me and Koku Bodhi is here, he is an associate in the film. We went to Gwalior and we went to Gwalior jail and spent 2 days with Pearl Lady over there. And she was instrumental in guiding us through all the locations. You know, things which were in our mind, we need something like this. So it was very easy for a writer or a director to sit in a room and imagine a place that may not be there. But they were there. She guided us through, she told us of how characters, how the courts were on the run, how did we chase for the police, and the different locations we had, like, I need a place where I want to report with the Rawails. And she pinpointed everything on a...
So, this was coincidental that you thought of a location, you didn't know whether it existed.
Yeah, we knew the Rawails.
But it did exist and couldn't have told you that it was.
She did not know. She knew the whole thing absolutely. You know, back of her hand.
So after thousands of films on dacoits that had been made before, suddenly there was this film which broke the mold. And as we know, there was Bandit Queen later, which was extremely authentic, same terrain, based on the life of Poolan Devi, incidentally, who was your guide. But anything else that you think you must have done in these films that made them different from the ones before them?
I think shock them honestly. That made all the difference.
What, sorry again?
I said shock them honestly. It was shock from the bottom of your heart. Okay. And the only way you can make a film is when it comes from the heart. And Paresh Rahul's character in that, as I don't think to me here, but seen it.
We'll show a clip of that also, Paresh Rawal in the pit.
That character which became iconic was suggested by Poolan Devi. She suggested this kind of a cop who existed in that place. And if you remember, we went to Morena to scout locations, we met a cop who's character. And we entered and said, you know, where is the SP? And there's a sahab telling me, oh, you have a keen daku aayega, to unsa photo chhare. And that was a strange kind of thing.
Keen daku aane wale hain, unke saath SP saab photo khichare. Wo kal aane wale hain daku, ye aaj photo khichare.
This is strange. It's really strange. This is a country we
need. Yeah, and then suddenly all of this came into cinema. Incidentally, I was shocked. I was a young boy when I saw Dakhayat in Jamshedpur talkies. And I was shocked to see this guy sleeping with the wife of the person who he has caught.
Exactly.
And this sirf matlab uske character ko establish karne ka ploy tha, because that was not the part of the story at all. But it was, he carried that horror through the film because of what he used to do with that woman.
But Imtiaz, I have to remind you one thing. This is a conversation between two directors,
yes.
Right? And it's not India's talking only about Rahul.
Of course.
Right? So I think we need to get that outcome. There's one thing about Imtiaz, you know, his films have always been up there for me. It's one honest filmmaker. His honesty shows in all his films. And I don't know if there are too many people who know about this, but there's a short film which he made. It's a 7 or 8 minute short film, which when I mentioned it to him, Imtiaz was quite surprised that I remembered that. And I do, because it's embedded in my memory. I've got a clip of that short film. And I'd like you guys to see it.
Yeah.
It's very long. So it's very long. Do you want to do it at the end of the session? Right now.
Long or short?
Right now.
There are a few more questions I have to ask you.
You can ask me anytime. But right now I'm extremely keen.
Okay.
All these people here, kids, I could say, to watch this short film.
Okay.
सेंसेक्स क्रैश, पर जिसने उस वक्त खरीदा वो आज किधर है?
स्टार्टिंग से
उसके पास तो अपना खुद का जहाज है.
हाँ बोल क्या हुआ? अरे पर अभी तो आया था बाहर में स्टॉक एक्सचेंज से. क्या कह रहा है? क्या बकवास कर रहा है? हाँ ऐसा कैसे गिर गया? मतलब तो क्या गिर गया? क्रैश बोले तो? अरे और एक्सीजी संक्रमण वो भी? अरे यानी जिधर पे मैंने पैसा डाला था वही स्टॉक डूब गया.
बैंक के शेयर में इन्वेस्ट किया होगा तूने.
ए चुप, ये तेरे बाजार की बात नहीं हो रही है. अच्छा बैंक के सारे शेयर गिर गए? बैंक और फाइनेंस
बाकी सब भी गिरेगा.
पूरा का पूरा क्रैश
लग गई तेरी. अब तू इस बाजार में दलाली कर.
झापट मारे ना मान.
छू के दिखा ना.
अरे ये हुआ कैसे ये तो बता.
यूएस फेडरल रिजर्व रेट बढ़ाया होगा और क्या.
अच्छा ये फेडरल रिजर्व का करेक्शन है क्या?
ये तो पता था होने वाला है.
पता किसको? क्या पता माँ? क्या पता?
अंधा है क्या तू? दो हफ्ते से न्यूज में बोले तुझे दिखता नहीं है? इन्फ्लेशन ऊपर है, फिस्कल डेफिसिट इतना बड़ा, तेल के दाम छप्पर फाट.
तो
यही तो करते हैं रिजर्व वाले. डॉलर की वैल्यू तो रखनी है ना, दुनिया डॉलर पर ही चलती है.
अरे ये डॉलर की वैल्यू मेंटेन करने के लिए सब नाटक है, समझा तू? करना क्या है? क्या क्या करना है? अरे बेचना है. करना क्या है? पहले वो पुलमेल वाला स्टील बेच दो और उसके बाद जो बचा है वो सारा का सारा बेच दो बस.
मतलब तेरा सारा पैसा डूब गया?
अरे जो मिलता है उसे पकड़ो और निकलो.
टोटल लॉस है, बड़े दुख की बात.
तो क्या कर सकते हैं इसमें?
अबे उल्लू यही टाइम है.
क्या क्या टाइम है?
जब कल डिसाइड होता है. कल भी धंधा ही करना है, इधर बेचो उधर खरीदो, 2% का मुनाफा नुकसान. क्या कल कुछ बनना है?
अरे इधर बना बनाया सब डूब रहा है, कल क्या घंटा बनना है?
देख अब सारी कंपनीज ने इतनी भारी गड़बड़ तो की नहीं होगी ना कि सबका स्टॉक गिरेगा.
नहीं
ना. तो इसका मतलब क्या है? सुधार आने वाला है?
एक मिनट रुक. अरे पता है रुक. हाँ तू इतना श्योरली कैसे कह सकती है?
2008 में क्या हुआ था?
रिसेशन.
लेमन ब्रदर्स बैंकक्रप्ट, रातों रात एफडीआई का सारा पैसा निकल गया, सेंसेक्स क्रैश. पर जिसने उस वक्त खरीदा वो आज किधर है?
उसके पास तो अपना खुद का जहाज है. मेरा मामा तो होता है वो. अब सुन मेरी बात सुन, अब हम बेचेंगे नहीं खरीदेंगे. कौन सा खरीदना चाहिए?
ब्लू चिप वाले शेयर. अभी
ब्लू चिप वाले सारे शेयर खरीद लो. हा? अरे दाखला तरीके वो इन्फोसिस और वो
एल एन टी
बीएचईएल
हिंदुस्तान लीवर
टाटा मोटर्स एक्सेट्रा. अरे मेरा मतलब है इन सारे शेयर पर लगा दो, सारा का सारा लगा दो, टोटल लगा दो. अरे शोर से भी ज्यादा शोर, 1 करोड़ टका शोर। देख यही है मौका, लगा दो चौका। जय भारती जी।
तू स्टूडेंट है क्या? क्लास प्लास करती है क्या तू फाइनेंस की?
बन सकती है तू इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंकर, बता रहा हूं मैं।
एक बात कहूं?
हाँ बोल।
तू मेरी चिंता तो मत कर, अपना मैं खुद ही संभाल लूंगी। अपनी सोच, 6.5 मिनट बाकी बचे हैं, जो करना है जल्दी करो, निकल यहां से। चल
and looks out and has this particular and a peculiar smile on her face. It's the first time the girl realizes what a freelancer is. Told she's been kidnapped. For me, that was absolutely brilliant. I mean, I was the one person who stood up and clapped. For me, it was a moment of celebration. I will not forget that. I will not forget a shot in your film with Bebo and Jabu Nath. We see lots of those shots in the snow.
Right.
But there was one shot in that song where she's singing with her back, she's standing with her back to the jeep and the child is driving and she's singing and the camera is going through this whole patch of snow and now for me, that shot made me feel cold. Which is great because the director could really bring that expression up. It's very rare. And you've done it multiple times. You've done it every time. You got away with Rishi Kapoor.
You got away with Rishi Kapoor
being played in a flashback by Selfie Khan. I really want to know how you managed that.
I don't know. I think people just like to believe. I think the only...
No, it was seamless. Nobody even pointed this out. Rishi Kapoor was not there and Sefali was not there. So, you had this great...
I really feel because I, as I'm saying, started my journey in a small city watching films on a large screen, films by directors like yours, and you go into the cinema theatre to believe and to enjoy. You know, that audience, like, they don't go in there to challenge anything. All they want is to be entertained and to be taken on a journey, to be taken on a ride.
Yeah, you actually go and believe. When you are convinced that what you are seeing, you are convinced what's happening.
Yeah.
You're right. If you're not convinced, the audience is going to ask you 10 questions.
Absolutely.
Why has this happened? With Highway, I had a great connect because somewhere the atmosphere of the hut where they lived reminded me of Betab.
Yes, because it's in the same terrain. In the Betab, so there is a place in Pahalgam, for those who have gone to Kashmir and to Pahalgam, there's a place which is called the Betab Valley. That is because of his film Betab. And yeah, so this scene that he's talking about, it reminds him of Betab because it is shot in Aru, which is just ahead of Pahalgam, so it's close to Betab Valley.
And since I've seen that area, I've filmed there, it was very real. You know, that's the kind of houses they live in.
They call it Doka.
Yeah. And all your films, Rockstar, I think gave a different dimension to music. And Ranbir Kapoor, I think, has one of the best songs.
That reminds me, sir, the background music of Arjun. It was very unconventional. So while you were making it, did you face resistance? Who came up with these ideas? Who was the background music director?
The background music was done by Pancham, Hari Barman.
Yes.
He did all the background. That one sequence...
How did this very different sound come? Like, I have so many clips, but I think we might not have time and we should get Atika on stage first. But how did it come to his mind or to your mind that we should have background like this with that ha-ha-ha-ha sound and all?
Yeah, I know, in that umbrella
sequence. Do we have time? Can we show that one sequence, please?
Yes.
Now please, I'd like you to see many sequences from his films. I've got 8. Atika, we'll just...
Yeah. Why don't you just show them the films?
Just this umbrella sequence, you must... And go, listen to the background music, okay? I'm telling you, there was no human sounds ever in background music before this. Just listen to this.
Umbrella.
so many umbrellas were bought by the producer for this one.
Yeah, yeah. We had 1,000 people holding 2,000 umbrellas.
Things which should be really spoken about.
So tell me now, how did you, can you ask Atika come?
Yeah, yeah, I mean, this is a good time to call.
Yeah, can we have Atika?
Atika.
Please go to the end.
Thank you very much for being so patient.
आजम तो हो गई, हम कह रहे हैं पिक्चर बनाओ एक आई एज अ वुमन व्हेन आई सी इमतियाज़ फिल्म्स और राहुल की आपकी फिल्में भी हम लोगों ने बचपन में देखी थी.
अच्छा, व्हाई डज एवरीबडी हैव टू टेल मी और बोल रहा है आप के बात को बदल ले इमतियाज कहता है जब मैं बताता हूं उसे Why do I have to repeat this whole thing?
So I think the young audience over here has to all promise to watch Rahulji's films. Definitely watch Arjun and my favorite is also Dakait sir. Definitely watch his films and then call him and say, sir, maine aapki film kal hi dekhi hai.
बाप से कह रहा है कि मैं घर छोड़ के भाग जाऊंगा, बाप कह रहा है मैं जाने नहीं दूंगा. मैंने आपको मैं बता रही थी, मैंने आपको मैसेज किया था. चलती रहती है, टीवी पे आती रहती है इम्तियाज की फिल्में और मैं ऐसे हर बार जब मैंने उनकी फिल्म देखी एक बात मैंने नोट की, इनकी फिल्मों में जो लड़का होता है वो फूट फूट के रोता है. बहुत बहुत बड़ा स्टेटमेंट थी. आपने रियलाइज किया है कि प्रोटैगनिस्ट होता है, जो हीरो होता है वो बिंदास बिना मुंह छुपाए बिना आंखों के हाल रखे फूट फूट के रोता है अपने हीरो के सामने. बाहर ऐसे फूट फूट के रोता है. न जाने क्यों, कोई तो बात थी जो आप कहना चाह रहे थे लेकिन आप साफ साफ नहीं कह रहे थे. लेकिन आदमी और औरत की जो रिलेशनशिप है और खास तौर से आदमी में जो पोर्ट्रेयल है जिस तरह से आपने दिखाया अपनी फिल्मों में, आई कैन स्पीक ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ वुमेन दैट आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू यू. अच्छा, ये एक पैटर्न हुआ या देयर इज अ पीस ऑफ योर लाइफ देयर और एनी इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ योर हैपनिंग ऑफ योर लाइफ, कैसा ये कॉमन क्यों है तुम?
Well, I feel it is said that cinema is aspirational. I think cinema is also aspirational for the writers and the directors that make their cinema. I feel that in their movies, in our movies, we try to do those things that they have been unable to do in life. I have never been able to cry. At least before, as a young man, I used to feel, my mother used to tell me that I'm heartless. As a joke, but the fact that I never had that, and it was sometimes I felt like, but I couldn't do the physical reaction of crying, you know. And maybe aap keh rahe hain, I've never thought of it before, but then as you pointed this thing out, it must be because of certain aspiration that I might have had to come to that level of catharsis. And I feel that most good things in life are facilitated by women. The only way that anybody could reach that stage is because of a certain softness, a certain love that only a woman is capable of giving, I think. And I might be biased. My interest is not in myself or in men as much as it is in women. I'm very fascinated by women of all kinds. I was guilty to admit it earlier, now I'm old enough to say that on the stage. I find them very beautiful, very sensitive and provocative. and that's the reason why these characters like Mahabhi Bhatti and Ivy can break down. Breaking down is not, I think, a statement of grief. It is always a statement of happiness.
Now जी आपने ये बात नोट की थी. Now that we comparing the two generations, you've been a prolific filmmaker, he's been a prolific filmmaker, और दोनों ने अपने अपने दौर में जो flavour था cinema का वो बदला. कहते हैं कि art imitates life and also life also imitates art. Do you agree with that? आपकी जो फिल्मों में इतना रोष देखा हमने कि वो जो इतने बड़े बड़े डागर्स देखे मारने जा रहा है और उसके बाद वो लड़का सनी देओल अकेला लड़का है खड़ा हो गया सरिया लेके मतलब आने दो कोई बात नहीं है और दोस्ती का जमाना जब खड़े हो जाते थे तो डिड यू सी दीज थिंग्स हैपनिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर आईज
यस एंड आई हैव सीन अ लॉट ऑफ दिस एंड ये फिल्म बनी थी उस दौरान में जब एजुकेटेड अनएम्प्लॉयड था एक बहुत बड़ा प्रॉब्लम आज भी है लेकिन उस समय में बहुत ज्यादा था And the anger in the education unemployed was at a peak. It would be obviously. They were not getting the right job. So that was where the character stepped in. Wo Josh wo pura usme tha. So what I've seen these characters and seen them very closely. And as far as crying goes in film, you said you don't cry. I love crying movies. I love sitting in a film and crying buckets and buckets of tears. And I think it would be great satisfaction to cry. I may sound sick, but that's what it is.
Sir, you are the man who's calling the shots in a film. Kya aapka Nayak ro sakta tha? Kya Sunny Deol ro sakta tha? Aapka jo hero hai bade par, kya wo ro sakta tha ek scene mein?
Yeah, ro sakta tha, there were instances in Arjun where he does cry. Maybe he did not cry as loudly as he should have. But there were, his tears were there. He was actually controlling his tears. But what Imtiaz has done is, jo Rona hai, is the two-way man would react, where Radeep cries when he sees that woman, and then when he sees the house. And I think it was more of an emotion that he's coming to a life he's never seen. He's never seen a woman, and he realizes the contribution a woman can have in a man, and that actually changes it. Yes.
और एक दिलचस्प बात है इम्तियाज आपकी फिल्म में आपने अगेन शायद कॉन्शियसली ये नहीं डाला मैं देखिए पॉइंट आउट कर रही हूँ आपकी चीज़ें जो एज अ व्यूअर मैं समझ रही हूँ शायद आपने समझते हुए ये बात ना करी हो जब भी मैट में यू वी रिमेम्बर शाहिद कपूर एक थोड़ा सा डिस्टर्ब इंसान है जिसकी माँ किसी के साथ भाग गई है राइट अब हमारे पॉपुलर जो स्टीरियोटाइप्स हैं वो ये हैं कि माँ मेरे बाप के अलावा किसी और से कैसे प्यार कर सकती है हमें यही बताया है हमारे पेरेंट्स एक्सक्लूसिव है दूसरे के लिए एंड में आपकी जो नायिका है वो सब समझाती है तो वहाँ बीच में प्यार में थी और उसको ये पूरी फिल्म लगी समझने में कि आई हैव टू फॉरगिव एंड लेट गो माय मदर सिंपल सी बात वो प्यार है दूसरी बात लवाशन में आपकी जो नायिका है वो शादी करके चली जाती वो शादी तक कंफ्यूज है कि मैं करूं कि मैं नहीं ना हूं कि मैं नहीं टू बी और नॉट टू बी एंड आई थिंक आई मीन वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस ऑन द टेबल आल्सो दैट मॉर्निंग वी वर टू से विद अ कपल ऑफ मेकर्स कि वो वापस आ जाती है क्योंकि मैं नहीं हो पाती मैं मेरे बिना नहीं रह सकती शादी के बाद छोड़ कर सो आपने छोटे 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 इंस्टेंसेस के जरिए बहुत लाउडली नहीं लेकिन जो हमारे पॉपुलर स्टेरियोटाइप्स हमको दिए गए हैं स्कूल्स कॉलेजेस पॉपुलर फिल्म्स में शादी एक बार होती है प्यार एक बार होता है हम एक बार शादी करते हैं यू टोल्ड दैट टू आवर चिल्ड्रन वी आर सो पास टाइम ऑन अस यू हैव ब्रोकन दैट डू यू रियलाइज दैट एट ऑल
I do not realize that and definitely it's not conscious as you said. So I think I have been asked this question in different ways and I've thought about it a lot and I feel now that what I write in my scripts and what comes into my films is not what I know. What comes into my films is what I'm engaged with and I don't have an answer for. अगर मुझे कोई किसी चीज का आंसर पता है तो मैं उसकी स्क्रिप्ट लिखूंगा नहीं, मैं बोर हो जाऊंगा कि मुझे तो मालूम है हो गया, मेरे अंदर वो जर्नी खत्म हो चुकी है, मगर जो अधूरा है जो मैं जिससे मैं कंफ्यूज हूँ या जूझ रहा हूँ या मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि ये ऐसा क्यों है, मैं ऐसा क्यों फील करता हूँ, जिसके जवाब मेरे पास नहीं है, वो मेरी फिल्मों में आते हैं। तो वो है कि लड़की कंफ्यूज है, मुझे समझ नहीं आ रहा है कि मैं जाऊं कि नहीं जाऊं आगे, बिकॉज लॉजिक इज सेइंग समथिंग एंड द हार्ट इज सेइंग समथिंग एल्स। आई हैव फाउंड माय सेल्फ इन दैट सिचुएशन इन डिफरेंट वेज अ लॉट एंड आई गेस दैट्स व्हाई इट कम्स थ्रू इन द फिल्म्स। आई एम नॉट in a position to tell anybody what how it should be, but I'm just in a position to observe the weaknesses and the frailties in myself.
आप दोनों ने बहुत बड़े एक्टर्स के साथ काम किया है और उनको लॉन्च भी किया है। आपने ऐश्वर्या राय को लॉन्च किया, काजोल, सनी देओल, मेनी अदर्स, एंड देयर सब्सिक्वेंटली बिकम बिग स्टार्स। यू हैव वर्क्ड विद बिग स्टार्स लाइक शाहरुख, लाइक रणवीर, लाइक दीपिका, सो मेनी। अभी हमने तो देखी नाना देवर स्टार्स, and the resounding applause that you got from viewers was maybe more, maybe better, more profound than what you got in films with a top-notch
You are absolutely right, because if that short film has stars, you would lose the essence of that film. You would lose the characters because of the people. See, all stars come with the baggage. No, they come with the baggage. So, if the baggage of actors on that short film, we would have lost it. That's where I give a lot of credit.
So, if you
when you're
trying to make a film, your preference is an actor?
See, my preference is an actor. I'm sure that every director will want a very good and suitable actor to play the part. But I think the audience or people over here definitely are smart enough to understand that there is a lot of money that is needed to make a film. It is the most expensive way of creating art or telling your story. If you borrow that money from somebody, that somebody is entitled to expect it back. So there is also a business that crores and crores of rupees have to be dealt with, you know. And then, so sometimes the distributor says, see, you are making the product, right? There is some dukaan kisi aur ki hai, big car, bech koi aur raha hai, uski apne अंडरस्टैंडिंग होती है कि देखो भाई ये सब होगा इंग्रेडिएंट तो इस भाव में बिकेगा तो तुम इतने में बना सकते हो। दैट रिवर्स कैलकुलेशन whether we admit it or not, tells you what you say that exists, right?
Of course, it exists very much, but taking stars, does it guarantee your money coming back?
Not at all.
I think what guarantees your money coming back and making more money is the quality of the film, which is dependent completely. This is my take, is completely dependent on the director. The director controls the film, the director makes the film, it's his vision, which takes it ahead. I agree with you, people on stars, but they should realize that stars don't, you know, guarantee you money coming back.
And
secondly, no star is born. Everybody has the first time. But now stars are believed that they know more about filmmaking, which is irritating for me. To me, they don't know anything, right? They believe they know everything. And there are filmmakers and directors who believe, yes, the star knows everything. It's a sad state.
Yes, in fact, at 11:30 in the morning, Dolly Alwalia is sitting She got the National Award for Bandit Queen in the film that you were just talking about. Sometimes very good technicians, very good artists are not able to do their work because so much do's and don'ts attached to stardom.
I'd like to say something in continuation of what Rahul ji said. See, we have come here to make movies. We'll make movies. Whatever the rules of the game is, we'll try to change it, bend it, we'll adjust, but we will not make movies, right? That is how I think. There are, in my own case, if anybody looks at the successes and failures of my movies, this point is proof. The movie has to be good for it to be commercially a success and for people to get their investment back. There is a little bit more vision that we require from the fraternity in the film industry that sells the films. They should also see the quality of the film. I understand that it is not a number. You know, they need to understand the community that assesses the value of a forthcoming film. Hamari picture in this film industry mein kya hota hai na, maal bikta pehle ya banta baad mein. It's a problem. There's a certain typicality to this trade. But the people who are selling it should have the vision to say that this is the story. They should get a little qualitative, not only quantitative. That vision is required for them to believe in somebody's vision, somebody's story. Then a director can make the right film and have greater chances of success with or without stars. That is a request from, I'm sure, all directors of this film industry. That vision will entitle us to make better films.
Acha, aapki film Love Aajkal ki jo sequel hai, Rase Aajkal,
Police
ki sequel. Can we call it?
Actually, I'm not supposed to be talking about that film. Film of Time is releasing, hopefully, if all goes well, in February.
Correct. Ek creative director ka jo ye kahani sunata hai, aapki filmon mein mujhe samaj ke ansh dikhte hain, aapke apne bachpan ke ansh dikhte hain. The way it can impact me as a viewer, the young boys and girls of the country, your films impact them. When you are not making a film, what process are you yourself going through? Because har bada insaan gurudat bane because of the tremendous problem that he had in his life. He's worked with Raj Kapoor sahab. Raj Kapoor sahab ke bhi jo parde par wo dalte the, bahut kuch unke apne andar se nikal ke aata, unki apni shakhsiyat ka aina hota tha wo. तो आप जो भी ब्रांड बन जाते हैं उस ब्रांड का दरअसल जो मसौदा होता है जो डिग्रेंट्स होते हैं वो उस क्रिएटिव इंसान के अंदर से निकल के आते हैं वो क्या है हाउ वेयर व्हाट इज दैट प्लेस यू गेट इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम मैं आपका इंस्टाग्राम देखती हूँ यू कॉन्स्टेंटली ट्रैवलिंग आई थॉट हाईवे में जो आपका ट्रक ड्राइवर है जो लेवल क्लास का आदमी है वो आपको कहीं ना कहीं किसी रोड पर मिला होगा कभी जिसे देख कर आपने सोचा होगा ये नायक हो सकता है मेरी कहानी का सो वॉट इज आप अपने आप को व्हाट यू सब्जेक्ट योर सेल्फ टू इन ऑर्डर फॉर यू टू चर्न आउट
I think for me, the influential part of life is not all real. Some of it is fictional. Yani ki agar main koi cheez dekhta hu aur koi insaan hai ya main khud kisi incident se guzarta hu, uske ilawa jo ho sakta tha aur shayad hua ho aur ab wo ladki jo wahan se aa rahi thi shayad wo us ghar se aa rahi ho, ye jo imagination ki duniya hai, tasavvur ki jo duniya hai na, ये हमेशा से चलती रही है और हर चीज का हो जाना हर चीज से गुजर जाना जरूरी नहीं रहा है अक्सर मेरी जिंदगी में मतलब द स्टोरीज दैट आई हैव रिटन आर आल्सो अ लॉट अबाउट थिंग्स दैट हैव नॉट हैपेंड डायरेक्टली इन माय लाइफ बट बिकॉज ऑफ इमेजिनेशन बिकॉज ऑफ अ सर्टेन टाइप ऑफ सेंसिटिविटी आई माइट हैव फेल्ट समथिंग वेरी स्ट्रांगली फ्रॉम सम अदर पर्सन but not directly gone through that experience. I think those things become a part of my story because frankly, I'm not as dumb as Jonathan Jakarim, rock star. I don't even like Jim Morrison. I didn't like Jim Morrison very much when I was growing up myself. Or, you know, I have never missed a train. Right? But I have looked from, you know, from the train into the lanes of Ratlam and seen those houses and wondered how it would be to be that man standing in that house. And that, so I think, yeah, this whole thing of being half in imagination and half in reality, which is how life is still going on, till one day there is a crash ending to it, that is responsible for the film.
And this imaginative life that you lead. So, मैं भी आपसे गाड़ी की बोलने की, you are a very unlike movie personality. आजकल हमारा
ऐसा मत बोलिए, मैं बहुत try कर रहा हूँ कि director की तरह लगूँ. I want to be like how Rahul ji is.
You didn't want to be fat, huge.
No, just be, have that personality anyway.
No, the impression that people have from Bollywood is people very well dressed, very sharp. They are at the right place at the right time. Networking, PR, parties mein jaate hain, wahan kaam milta hai, which is not the reality. So what is the reality?
The reality is that in the bomb, मैं ये देखता हूँ सर कि ultimately चाहे जितनी दोस्ती हो आप, but काम जिसका अच्छा होता है ना, ultimately काम उसी के पास आता है. उस लिहाज से हर filmmaker selfish भी होता है, that he wants the best actor, he wants the best director. For, so I feel that it doesn't really matter. There are people who go to parties because they want to, and they also do well if they are good. And there are people who just don't socialize at all. Ranveer is not on any social media. He's doing pretty well. He's known to be a good actor. Other actors are on social media, and if they are good, they are also, you know, good actors and get a few. So it's not going to lena dena nahi. If you want to party, party.
What are the books that you read and the cinema that you watch when you're not making films?
I watch films of foreign language, actually, more than English or Hindi. Yeah, different. And usually they come by recommendation. Someone says it was a film. And it was to reach as one of my favorite directors. Bong Kar-wai is one of my favorite directors. So, us tarah ki jo film, sir watches a lot of South Indian films these days.
South Indian. You know, having been on the jury for the Panorama and the National Awards, having headed them for four times, it opened up a new world for me as far as Indian cinema goes. You know, this word regional cinema, I think, is redundant. In fact, the Hollywood, sorry, the Bombay Indian cinema needs to pull up their socks.
Yes.
Yeah.
With, you know, I hate that word Bollywood.
Yeah, so do I.
Yeah, I find that terrible. But
if we hate the word Bollywood, guys, try to say Bombay film industry.
Industry, yeah. You know, it's the Hindi film industry. And, I've seen films from Assam, from Ladakh, from Lakshadweep, made in a language which is spoken by only 60,000 people in the world, and it was a brilliant film. So seeing all those, I am now watching as many of the different language films I can, what I can get on the OTT platforms.
Great.
If not, I find them on YouTube. But I like to watch those kind of movies.
Okay, sir, आपके जो बेटे हैं,
भरत, भरत,
वो यशराज फिल्म्स में असिस्ट कर रहे हैं, फिलहाल ही इसमें असिस्टेंट डायरेक्टर।
भरत नॉट द असिस्टेंट एनीमोर, भरत हैंडल्स द क्रिएटर फॉर द एंटायर कंपनी, यू नो।
अच्छा।
But my younger son, Shiv, he's an assistant at Yashraj. I'm a proud father because he's going to launch his film as a director for Yashraj.
Oh, very good.
Very good. And best wishes to him.
And in fact, I told Adi that you have both my sons there, so why don't you adopt me? You know, I think that's important. But then I hope they do well. I hope they are balanced. They are pretty balanced.
Right. So the point is, sir, कि they are completely in tune with modern day times. आजकल क्या बिकता है, कैसी फिल्में लोग देखना चाह रहे हैं, उन्हें शायद पता होगा. Yeah, they are in the business. You knew कि 80s, 90s में क्या पिक्चर हिट हो सकती है, आपको एक अंदाजा था.
I got it.
Have you? Yeah,
17
films.
And 7 of them are with Sunny Deol.
7 films.
मैं दोनों से ये पूछना चाहती हूँ कि जब आप स्क्रिप्ट लिख रहे होते हैं और एक लड़का है एक लड़की है, एक तो इस जॉनरा से हम निकलते ही नहीं है कि कहानी इसके अलावा भी किसी चीज के बारे में हो सकती है, एक लड़का और लड़की के अलावा, लाइक वी हैव मेरे तब आई गॉट गूस पिंपल्स बना चाहो शिंडलर्स लिस्ट रोमन पोलंस्की पियानिस्ट एंड सो मेनी फिल्म्स कांजीवरम वाज अ मलयालम फिल्म अबाउट अ मैन जिसने अपनी बेटी को शादी में दहेज में साड़ी देने का वादा किया था जब वो पैदा हुई थी तो दे पाता है या नहीं दे पाता. सो ये रैंडम कहानियों पर बनी पिक्चर है, हमारे सिनेमा में पता नहीं क्यों आई नहीं रही है. सुई आके टिकी हुई है, एक लड़का था एक लड़की थी, एक था राजा एक थी रानी. एक तो ये कि ये कब टूटेगा, ये जो एक स्टीरियोटाइप है ये कब टूटेगा. दूसरा ये कि आपकी फिल्म भी अभी लैला मजनू द बॉय वॉज अ ब्यूटिफुल यंग बॉय एंड गर्ल वॉज अ ब्यूटिफुल यंग गर्ल एंड अ ब्यूटिफुल सेटिंग एंड नाइस म्यूजिक. Do you know and have you able to understand who's a good protagonist male and who's a good protagonist female? Have you understood the mantra? कि ये rose होने चाहिए, ये bones होने चाहिए. इसको जनता reject कर देगी.
I don't look at it in terms of जनता क्या reject करेगी या select करेगी. I have a certain imagination for a story and the characters in that story. I feel that this person has the vibe of that character. So let me, I think he'll be interesting in that part. Whether he'll be rich, my belief is that if a actor is very suited to the character, people would love that person. People would love that actor.
I agree with him. When I made a love story, Amjad Khan was Gabbar Singh.
Right.
He had this huge image of Gabbar Singh. And I needed a police constable in that, which is a very lovable character.
And almost comedian.
Comedian, absolute comedian. And when I suggested, let's take Amjad Khan for this, of course, they were, are you crazy? I said, why? It's not a question of, he's a person who is fitting in that role. And finally it happened and it's all
the same. Very, very popular.
But times are different. When I made Arjun, I think more time changed over there. People are concentrating on the films as they should be. When I made Arjun, after the film was complete, I told the producers, I said, let me remove Dimple from this. She's doing nothing. She's actually doing nothing. I said, in fact, she's disturbing the film. And the other thing is, that the film was running for a little over 2 hours and 1 minute. So I said, "Isko bhi aur kam kar deta hoon." To unko laga ye aadmi pagal ho gaya. They forced me to add scenes to make it longer. And times have changed now.
Yeah.
So I'm glad they've really changed. And Imtiaz made a film called Sochanatha. To me, Sochanatha was probably the first film which addressed the youth of today, I mean at that period. Before that, I used to hear this sentence from a lot of filmmakers, I'm making a film about the youth. So I said, okay, what are you making? I'm shooting it in Cafe Coffee Day. I mean, come on, you were shooting in Cafe Coffee, it doesn't make any good film. You know, a film needs much more. And, Sochanatha, I think, was revolutionary, though the film didn't do well, unfortunately. But I still consider it to be his best film.
Yes, yes.
And I, I think it's something to be very proud of.
Yeah.
And at times, when I see it again, I do see it again. I really wish that I had made this film here. What was wrong with me here? That was really something.
सर, आपने राज कपूर जी को असिस्ट किया बहुत लंबे वक्त तक और उनकी खासियत ये थी कि वो अपनी फिल्म की म्यूजिक पर ना बाकायदा खुद बैठा करते थे. इम्तियाज जी के साथ भी ये मशहूर है इनका पता नहीं, लेकिन मैं जानती हूँ कि आप म्यूजिक के में बैठते हैं विद अ कीन ईयर कि इट्स अ मेक और ब्रेक थिंग फॉर अ फिल्म. क्यों ऐसा क्यों?
Because it's the most entertaining part of making movies for me.
अच्छा.
अब मुझे बहुत मजा आता है इस प्रोसेस में कि आपको बैठना है, गाने सुनाएगा, म्यूजिक की बात होगी, इसको को ऐसे चेंज करो, इसके पैसे मिल रहे हैं, रात भर बैठे रहो आप।
मैं बैठता हूँ म्यूजिक सिटी में क्योंकि रिवाज है कि भाई डोंट सी इन द म्यूजिक सिटी या डायरेक्टर्स कॉल्स मी दैट आई हैव नो सेंस ऑफ म्यूजिक आई डोंट नो नथिंग अबाउट इट आई कैन हियर इट एंड टेल यू इफ दिस साउंड गुड और साउंड बैड बट इफ यू नो नेटिव नेटिव्स आई डोंट नो देम दैट्स ऑल आई कैन से उस टाइम पे दो गाने सुनाए थे ऐसे बैठे हुए एक गाना था झूठ बोले कौवा काटे The entire song I had heard in 68, used in 72 in Bobby. So that song is Simpsons. And the other was Sunsara Sun, which also I had heard in 68, the complete song. And he used it in Ram Tere Bhagwan again. So he had, a great sense of music. And he could actually play any instrument.
और इनका रिश्ता ए आर रहमान से इतना खूबसूरत रिश्ता है कि तुम इतनी छोटी सी फिल्म हो या चाहे बहुत बड़े मैन हो
या आपने देखा ना जो ये फिल्म दिस इज इम्तियाज अली एंड ए आर रहमान
इमेजिन दिस शॉर्ट फिल्म में भी व्हाट इज द रिलेशनशिप दैट यू शेयर विद रहमान इट्स अनयूजुअली ब्यूटीफुल
या आई थिंक ही इज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ अ ऐसा कुछ नहीं उनकी वजह से मुझे लोग ऐसा बोलते हैं बिल्कुल ऐसा नहीं है मैं तो सिंस आई हैव कमिटेड एंड कंटिन्यू टू एंड आई एम प्लानिंग टू कमिट
मिसाल के तौर
पर वो मैं आपको बताऊंगा बाद में एसएमएस करूंगा आपको बट आई थिंक एक बार उनके बर्थडे मैसेज में मैंने बोला था एंड आई थिंक आप बोलने के बाद मुझे लगा कि ये सही है जो पुराने जमाने में जब कॉम्पस नहीं होता था तो वो कहते हैं यू आर द स्टार ऑन माय होराइजन बिकॉज़ इट शोज मी द वे सो मुझे लगता है कभी-कभी ना वो एक ऐसा वाला तारा है मेरे होराइजन में रहमान की अच्छा दैट्स द वे तो इट्स अ गाइडेंस आई माइट नॉट गो इन दैट डायरेक्शन बट समवेयर शोज मी द वे आई थिंक दैट अबाउट इट
आप दोनों के बच्चे हैं आप लोग भी उसी दौरान उसी फेज से होकर गुजरे डू यू थिंक हमारी स्कूलिंग हमारे कॉलेज या जो हम पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं वो कामयाब हो रही है उस चीज में जिसका जो उसका पर्पस था इज इट टर्निंग आउट ब्राइट इंडिविजुअल्स विद अ विजन हु वांट टू चेंज द वर्ल्ड हु वांट टू मेक द वर्ल्ड अ बेटर प्लेस वुड यू हैव चेंज समथिंग अबाउट योर एजुकेशन
नो एजुकेशन आई थिंक इज अ रियल मस्ट In fact, to all people here in the audience who want to become filmmakers, I have two pieces of advice. One is, do complete your education, because it will open you up to the world. You will start understanding the world. The second is, don't get married. So one simple reason, once you're married, you're looking at me surprised. Once you're married, then you have restrictions. Yeah, main ye karunga, it's a risk. I have a family to look after. When you're not married, you don't get a dance. Alright? I made a film called Love Story. It's the only film in the world which does not carry a director's name. Yeah, it doesn't.
This is something I didn't want to bring up from this.
It's the only film in the world.
Director ka naam nahi.
I got a court order. I had a problem with the producer after the film was complete. So I said, I don't want my name on it. And the producer wanted to give his name. So I went to court. And the court said, you can't give your name. If he doesn't want to give his name, that's up to him. So it's the only film in the world which does not carry a name. Now I did this.
शादी
नहीं की थी
अच्छा तो ये कर सकते
हैं। तो कर सकता था। I will those days come back when I can still go back to America, but it's too late. So you could take this step.
हम लोग हर दिन इवॉल्व हो रहे हैं, हर साल हर 10 साल पे हम एक नया जन्म लेता है हमारे अंदर एक इंसान। व्हेन यू कंपेयर योरसेल्फ टू द 20-year-old इम्तियाज एंड नाउ
20-year-old the process in which films were being made in Bombay did not suit me. जैसे कि actor decide करेगा, अच्छा मैंने actor बना के मिला हुआ ये करो क्यों करेगा? After so many years of working, but I won't make a film now. And this has happened at EP. It happened in Kurti, EP 2019. There is a anthem which is based on the Norris, the 9 emotions. Seeing that, it has really worked in my mind that I should make an anthology, maybe 10 minutes each of these 9 emotions. But I look at the emotions in my way. But the inspiration has been from EP 2019.
एक चीज जो हो गई है मुझे लगता है एक बिजनेस इज वेरी मायोपिक व्हाट आई मीन इज दैट सट्टे बाजार की तरह हो गया ये फिल्म पहले फ्राइडे में 2 शो में इसने अगर अच्छा नहीं किया तो इसका मतलब इसको उतार दो डोंट गिव इट अ चांस देयर आर मूवीज दैट आर मेड विद लेगेसी देयर आर मूवीज दैट आर मेड विद लव देयर आर मूवीज दैट आर नॉट जस्ट a T20 match, you know, they can give you a lot of money, but you have to be patient. So I feel that, again, the business fraternity should do business not like the stock market, but like a regular market.
Like creative people.
Not even, not creative people, but you have to understand that when you picture banate hain, jab Rahul ji or main or koi director picture banata hai, to usko malum hota hai, कि ये हमेशा के लिए दिस इज फॉरएवर हम मर जाएंगे ये फिल्म फिर भी देखी जाएगी तो आप उस लेगेसी को ध्यान में रखकर के पिक्चर बनाते हो और जजमेंट अगर इस लेवल पे हो रहा है ना कि इंटरवल में क्या रिएक्शन है पहले शो में ऑडियंस का तो दैट्स नॉट फेयर गिव इट अ चांस लेट इट एट लीस्ट गो डाउन फॉर अ फ्यू डेज सी व्हाट पीपल सेड आई थिंक द
टोटल डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ सिनेमा इन इंडिया इज that we have stopped making films. We are not shooting films. We are shooting numbers, which is the biggest crime. people are only bothered about what happens on Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I mean,
now it is just the Friday, sir.
Just the Friday. I mean, this is ridiculous.
एक मुझे किस्सा इस बात से आपकी बात से जोड़ रही हूँ. आपके फादर हैं जिस रवेल साहब ने एक बहुत अच्छी आपने लैला मजनू देखी है
पुरानी वाली.
कैसी आती है जिससे बोल लिखे थे वो उसका हर डायलॉग एक शेर है. हर डायलॉग राइम में बोला गया है. हाँ आप तो छोटे होंगे जब वो फिल्म बन रही होगी.
Imtiaz is on a pedestal for me, up there, because of the films he's made. My connection is not with the success, or it's with the film. Shole became a money spinner, it still is. But the film itself, you know, is something which you can't forget. Imtiaz is film like Highway. I can still talk to you about shots in that. You know, I can talk to you about shots in Love Aajkal. So that I think is what is to be achieved. But in today's times, when you're shooting numbers and you're shooting only for Fridays, you're not going to achieve
that. If you have a lot of money, I think that money is a very creative thing. Business is a very creative thing. क्योंकि आपको कंज्यूमर उसकी मेंटालिटी उसके बारे में थोड़ा लैटरल थिंकिंग रखनी पड़ती है. अगर आप सीधा बोलेंगे ना कि ओके सो इस पिछले पिक्चर में ये हीरो इसकी क्या ओपनिंग थी और इस डायरेक्टर के साथ इस कॉम्बिनेशन में कितना नंबर आना चाहिए तो ये नंबर आपका होगा तो ऑल इंडिया कितने में क्लोज करूँ और ऐसे नहीं. और आज तक ऐसा नहीं हुआ है कि ये जो भी कैलकुलेशन के बाद जो उन लोगों ने नंबर लाया हो वो एक्चुअली करेक्ट निकला हो फिर भी हर बार अपने आप को तसल्ली देने के लिए ये कोई नंबर ऐसे खड़ा कर देते हैं और हर बार वो नंबर गलत हो जाता है. यू नो समटाइम्स यू गॉट टू बी ब्रेव एंड से आई डोंट नो आई एम गोइंग विद माय गट फील.
दैट्स इट दैट्स राइट. आई थिंक यू नीड टू आस्क पीपल एनी क्वेश्चन.
ओके क्विकली वी विल टेक अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस.
यस
पूछिए
हेलो सर. माय नेम इज शुभम पांडे. आई एम एन एक्टर एंड एंकर. और मैं सर खटाना भाई के शहर से हूँ रॉकस्टार में जो समोसे की चटनी बनवाते हैं रीवा मध्य प्रदेश से. सर कभी मौका मिला तो मैं आपके पैर जरूर छूना चाहूँगा. कल टिकट ना मिलने का डर और आज वहाँ मिलने का डर सर मुझे रात भर नींद नहीं आ रही थी.
मैं आशा करूँगा कि मौका आपको कभी ना मिले. आपको मेरे पांव छू करके मुझे छोटा साबित करना
नहीं नहीं मैं आपको बड़ा उम्र दराज साबित करना चाहता
हूँ. उम्र दराज तो बता ही दिया कि उम्र दराज.
सर मेरी जिंदगी में कुछ फिल्म मुझे बहुत ज्यादा पसंद है जैसे कि जब वी मेट. इसने मेरे बचपन को बहुत खूबसूरत बनाया था. रॉक स्टार जो कि जवानी में मुझे लगता है कि हर एक वक्त पे कभी सुख हो या दुख हो मुझे हमेशा इंस्पायर करता है बड़े सपनों देखने के लिए उसमें बहुत सारी मेहनत करने के लिए. हमेशा तुम हो जो कि मेरी जिंदगी का सबसे फेवरेट गाना है. मेरा सवाल सर ऐसा है कि जैसे किसी इंसान को थोड़ा सा दुख होता है ना थोड़ा सा दिल टूटता है तो अक्सर सबसे पहले वो कवि बन जाता है. चार लाइन की पंक्तियां सबसे पहले लिख देता है. मैं भी लिखता हूँ सर. तुम हो जो सॉन्ग है मैं और मेरे दोस्त सिद्धार्थ के सबसे फेवरेट सॉन्ग है हमेशा सुनते रहते हैं. सर आप अपनी इंस्पिरेशन कहाँ से लाते हो सर.
अच्छा मैं आपको एक बात बोलना चाहता हूँ. सर ये पता नहीं क्यों दिमाग मेरा थोड़ा इस तरह से चलता है. यहाँ डॉली जी बैठी है डॉली आलू वाली. रॉकस्टार फिल्म में जो खटाना भाई जो है जिस तरह से वो दिखते हैं ना उनमें उसमें इनका बहुत ज्यादा योगदान है। डॉली जी प्लीज से स्टैंड अप। डॉली जी ने क्या किया उसमें, ठीक है उन्होंने कॉस्ट्यूम डिजाइन किया, कॉस्ट्यूम कोई डिजाइन कर सकता है, अच्छा करती है, हमेशा अच्छा ही करती है। डॉली जी ने एक बात बोला था कि हम लोग खटाना भाई में क्या करेंगे कि उसकी गर्दन पे ना थोड़ा सा ऐसे स्प्रे करके पसीने का टैल्कम पाउडर की धार लगाएंगे। टैल्कम पाउडर, ये जो ऑब्जर्वेशन थी, आप डॉली जी यू आर हियर एंड आई कैन टेल यू सो मेनी पीपल हैव टोल्ड मी कि यार वो खटाना भाई का जो था ना उसके यहाँ पे पाउडर करता था यार, ऐसा कभी देखा नहीं मैंने किसी भी फिल्म में। ये जो बात थी ये दिस हैज कम फ्रॉम डॉली जी।
मुझे पता है कि कुछ ना कुछ अलग करना होता है, बहुत अच्छा था सर, लेकिन ये रॉकस्टार का जो एंड सीन है सर उसके बारे में मैं आपसे आपकी मन से सुनना चाहूंगा, आपने ऐसा ही क्यों रखा? बहुत अच्छा लगता है सर जब रणवीर जो है वो बाथटब में सो रहे हैं, मतलब लेटे हुए हैं, लेकिन उनका गिटार चल रहा होता है, मतलब कहीं ना कहीं इंटरनल सोल अभी भी तृप्त नहीं हुई है, वो हीर से नहीं मिल पाया है, बहुत ज्यादा दुख है। और जब वो स्टेज पे परफॉर्म कर रहे होते लास्ट शो में तो उसकी हीर की सोल आती है, सर इसके बारे में आपसे सुनना चाहूंगा सर। रॉकस्टार के एंड के बारे में
इंसान अपने आप को ऐसे लेवल पे ले आता है कि जब उसको दुख का भी एहसास नहीं होता, अपने अंदर के सेंसिटिविटी को झकझोड़ने के लिए वो अपने आप को पिछले दुखों से बड़ा दुख, पिछले शॉक से बड़ा शॉक देना चाहता है, जस्ट टू फील अलाइव, जस्ट टू फील एनी डैम थिंग। गिटार किसी भी आर्टिस्ट का, किसी भी म्यूजिशियन का सबसे प्राइज्ड पोजेशन होता है, उसका भी था, उसी लिए उसने उस गिटार को जलाया और जला करके देख रहा है कि मुझे कुछ फील हो रहा है, कुछ दर्द फील हो रहा है, क्योंकि अगर दर्द फील हो रहा होगा इसका मतलब होगा कि मैं जिंदा हूं।
उस किस्म के डायरेक्टर है जिनमें एडिटर जो है उसका काम एक ही होता है कि शॉर्ट या जोड़ना और या काटना है। He's only got to do a mechanical job. So anybody can become one. His films are not films which an editor makes, and you can see the films and say that.
Hello. No, basically it's the same cut. Humne duration, mera hi decision tha that some scenes were kept out of the film. That was my decision, good or bad, I don't know.
So, hello. So my name is Ujjwal Dhawan. I'm a performing arts student. Huge fan of your work, sir. So my question is, as a director, you visualize the shot before even actually taking the actual shot.
Sure.
So as a director who writes his own movies, my question is, can a director reach his highest potentials, his truest potentials, if he has not written the movie? Can he feel the movie? I mean, you've written all your movies. If you're given a movie which you have not written, can you do justice to that movie?
I don't know whether I can, but most of the directors that I really admire are not writers themselves. It's not necessary for somebody to be a writer to be a good director. I feel that so many. I think, jaise Rahul ji ne kaha ki Javed saab was writing the film, I think, but you would brainstorm together.
Yes.
Yeah, you would brainstorm together. So technically, Rahul Rawail is not the writer for his film. There are, I think every director has a different way. Sometimes I feel that if a script comes to me, which I have not written, then I will be able to give a different point of view to it. You know, then I will not give only the director's point of view. Now, as a writer and director, I try to write and then I try to direct with a different take to it. So, I don't know, I don't think it's necessary for somebody to write his own stuff to do a good job as a director at all.
Hello, sir. सर कहानी से रिलेटेड मेरा सवाल है आपकी फिल्म तमाशा में सर आपने बहुत सारे फोक ड्रामास का यूज किया है तमाशा नाम ही एक महाराष्ट्र का फोक ड्रामा है तो सर जैसे उसमें रामलीला है रासलीला है लहरा मजनू शीरी फरार बहुत सारी स्टोरीज मतलब लव बर्ड्स हैं उसमें और उसके बाद अपने रणवीर कपूर और दीपिका पादुकोण में सर आज के समय में जो मतलब आपकी फिल्मों की स्टोरी होती है उसमें स्टोरी बिगनिंग मिडिल एंड पूरा होता है लेकिन आज के समय में बहुत सारी फिल्में बन रही हैं स्टोरी लेस मतलब फिल्म बन जाती है तब तक समझ में नहीं आता क्या स्टोरी थी मतलब स्टोरी और सिनेमा का बहुत रिलेशन है बहुत अच्छा है लेकिन आपके नज़रिए से सर कौन सी स्टोरी है जो आपको अट्रैक्ट करती है किस तरह की स्टोरी है जो आपको अट्रैक्ट करती है जैसे मैम ने ये पूछा किस तरह का सिनेमा आप नहीं देखना चाहते तो सवाल ये सर कि किस तरह का सिनेमा है जो आप क्रिएट करना चाहते हैं या किस तरह की स्टोरी है जो आपको अट्रैक्ट करती है और उन उन फोक ड्रामास की या उन स्टोरीज की जैसे कि आप राधा कृष्ण एक मूवी आपकी जो आपने बोला था अभी इंटरव्यू में तो उन मूवीज की क्या मतलब उन स्टोरीज की क्या वैल्यू है आज के समय
देखिए पहली बात तो ये कि इस सवाल पूछने के बहाने आपने जो पॉइंट रखा है वो पॉइंट मैं समझ गया और मुझे लगता है कि आपने बहुत अच्छे तरीके से तमाशा को देखा है और समझा है
सर मोबाइल में हमेशा रहती है जब मन होता है देख लेता हूँ
तो बहुत भला हो उस बंदे का जिसने मोबाइल बनाया वजह से कम से कम मैं मेरा कोई अंश आपकी पॉकेट में भी रहता है मोबाइल ना होता तो मैं भी ना होता बट आपने बहुत अच्छे से देखा है और जैसा कि आपने कहने कहा कि बहुत सारी कहानियां इर्द-गिर्द होती हैं और उसका रूपांतरण अभी की जिंदगी में देखना और आज के जमाने में उन्हीं कहानियों को देखना एक तरह से या उसी लैला को या उसी मजनू के किसी पार्ट को आज इस ऑडियंस में देखना ये मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है कभी कभी ऐसी फीलिंग भी आती है
यस सर आपसे एक सवाल और है आपने अभी बोला कि मैरिड व्यक्ति रिस्क नहीं ले सकता
आप पहले बताइए आप मैरिड हैं कि
नहीं सर अभी
कोई नहीं है
कौन मैं मजाक नहीं कर मैं कह रहा हूं मैं आपको एडवाइस दे रहा हूं तो सही एडवाइस
क्लियर नहीं है वो थोड़ा क्लियर कर दीजिए कि जैसे कि कुछ फिल्में हैं जैसे कि तमाशा मेरी पहली फिल्म है जो मैंने थिएटर में देखी थी और सर उस मूवी के इंटरवल में जैसे कि आपने अभी एक बात बोली कि लोग इंटरवल में जज कर देते हैं बहुत सारी पास की ऑडियंस थी क्या समझ में नहीं आ रहा क्या चल रहा है मतलब ऐसा रिएक्शन था उस ऑडियंस का उसके अलावा बर्फी जग्गा जासूस ऐसी कई फिल्में हैं जो ऑडियंस को मतलब पसंद नहीं है लेकिन वो मील का पत्थर है भारतीय सिनेमा का वो फिल्म है तो सर वो पर्सन जिन्होंने वो फिल्में क्रिएट की हैं उन्होंने रिस्क लिया है वो मैरिड है
लेकिन आपने रिसर्च ठीक से नहीं किया है
मगर मैं उस रिस्क की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ फिल्म बनाना रिस्क है जो इनिशियल रिस्क है जो इनिशियल फिल्म बनानी है आपको मैं ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ कि आप कभी शादी मत कीजिए और कुंवारे रहिए वो भी बैर नहीं होगा लेकिन रिस्क होता कि जब आप पहली फिल्म बना रहे हैं जब तक आप अपने आप को एस्टैब्लिश नहीं कर पाते तब तक मत कीजिए क्योंकि आपको रिस्क ऐसे मौके आएंगे वे यू बी एक्सपेक्टेड टू टेक अ रिस्क एंड यू विल ओनली टेक इट इफ यू हैव नो बैगेज बिहाइंड
सर रिलेशनशिप में रह सकते हैं रिलेशनशिप में रह सकते हैं जब तक
आप बिल्कुल रिलेशनशिप में ना होंगे और ना ना होंगे
रिलेशनशिप तो बेटा मैं भी घूम रहा हूँ
सर मैं अभिदोष शायद मेरे सवाल की आपको हंसी आ जाए लेकिन मेरे लिए बहुत सीरियस भी था। अगर कोई नया लड़का 25 साल का जो काफी समय से थिएटर और एक्टिंग फील्ड में है, एक्टर है खुद, आपके पास एक बड़ी खूबसूरत सी स्टोरी लेके आया जिस टाइप से आप सिनेमा बनाते हैं उसी टाइप से, और वो ये कहे सर मुझे कुछ नहीं चाहिए, मैं फ्री में काम करूंगा, बस मुझे इस स्टोरी में एज ए लीड काम करना है, तो आपका रिएक्शन क्या होगा? आपकी स्टोरी पसंद भी आती है अलग को?
मैं सुनूंगा ही नहीं कहानी, मैं उससे ये पूछूंगा कि तुम एक्टिंग करना चाहते हो या राइटर हो।
सर एक्टिंग करते 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 वो स्टोरी लिख ली अपनी आप?
तो स्टोरी लिख ली तो मैं तो खुद ही स्टोरी लिखता हूँ, तो मैं
इसीलिए
वो स्टोरी बनाना चाहूंगा जो मैं लिखता हूँ।
इसीलिए
मैं आपको एक बात बोलना चाहूंगा, अगर आप एक्टिंग करना चाहते हैं तो आप एक्टिंग कीजिए, और अगर आप लिखना चाहते हैं तो लिखिए। ऐसा नहीं हो सकता कि आप दो बोट में सवार रह सकते हैं, ऐसा भी नहीं होगा कि एक चीज दूसरे चीज को का बिगिनिंग करेगी। ऐसा नहीं होगा कि आपने बहुत अच्छी कहानी लिख दी मुझे एज ए लीड ले लो, ऐसे बहुत सारे लोग आते हैं, एंड मुझे नहीं लगता है कि ज्यादातर लोगों का कुछ हो पाता है।
लेकिन सर मतलब वो ऐसी चीज है मतलब कि पिछले जो कई सारे उसको कर रहा है, एक्टिंग में कर रहा है, सीख रहा है, पढ़ाई की है उसने उस बारे में, उसी को लेके की स्टोरी क्रिएट की है उसने पूरा एक
क्योंकि आपको ज्यादा शौक है एक्टर बनने का, आपने कहानी लिखी है सोच के कि इसमें एक्टिंग मैं करूंगा, तो ये नहीं होता है। जैसे इम्तियाज ने कहा आप दोनों में से एक काम कीजिए और फिर ग्रेजुएट आ गया पूरी दुनिया बाकी है।
Final decision to director का
नहीं होता। I think we have to wind up. If there is one last question, quickly ask.
Let's talk about the ladies.
My name is Chetan sir. Actually, one of my friend has written research paper on log style itself. He wants to be a research student. I am a student of BSD, and one of my friends has written a whole paper on log style research paper, and he has written certain things जो मैं उस समय समझ नहीं पाया था। जैसे एक आपने गाना जो उसमें आता है कि गगरे गगरे मोरी इतनी आदत तो से चुन चुन खाइयो मांस खाइयो नारे नैना मोरी, जो शेख फरीद ने लिखा है, तो जो क्योंकि उनका वो कह रहे हैं अल्लाह को कि मेरे मांस खा जाओ, मेरी आँखें मत खाओ कि मैं अल्लाह को और देखना चाहता हूँ, तो शायद आपने उसको अडेप्ट किया है। तो इस टाइप की जो इंस्पिरेशन जो आपके अंदर आती है सर, कि आप किस तरीके की स्टोरीज पढ़ते हैं, कुछ किस तरीके का वर्क देखते हैं, मैं आपसे पूछना चाहूँगा। मूवी देखते समय छोटे छोटे इंसिडेंट है जो निकल जाते हैं, हम लोग समझ नहीं पाते, बट जब कोई समझाता है या उस चीज़ों के पैमाने बताता है तो हमें पता चलता है कि नहीं ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट था किसी मूवी का।
सो ये चीज़ें जो है ना वो आपको मूव इसलिए करती हैं क्योंकि वो है ही बहुत मूवी, और बाबा फरीद ने लिखा है और उन्होंने जो अपनी जिंदगी में किया होगा देखा होगा और जो जो भी चीज लिखी है उसका जो ओरिजिन है जो जहाँ से वो चीज आई है जब आप तक पहुँचती है तो उसी वाइब्रेशन को लेके आती है जो उनकी जिंदगी की जर्नी रही है, और उसको मुझे लगता है कि हो सकता है कि कुछ लोग एग्जैक्टली समझ जाए कुछ लोग नहीं समझे, बट मेरे लिए उस लाइन का रॉकस्टार में जो सिग्निफिकेंस रहा है वो ये रहा है कि पूरी पिक्चर को इस एक लाइन ने एक आइडेंटिटी दे दी, क्योंकि लोगों को समझाना मेरा मकसद नहीं था, सबसे पहला मतलब मकसद नहीं था, मेरा मकसद था इस लाइन को खुद ही समझ जाना या समझना भी नहीं एक्सपीरियंस करना कि दादा सप्तन खाइयो चुन चुन खाइयो मास दो नैना मत खाइयो पिया मिलन की आस, ये उनकी ओरिजिनल लाइन थी, हम लोगों ने उसको थोड़ा सा खराब किया है पिक्चर में डालने के लिए, बट सो दिस बिकेम द ओवरऑल सेंसिटिविटी एंड द सेंसिबिलिटी ऑफ द फिल्म एंड इट गाइडेड द फिल्म रॉकस्टार टू बी व्हाट इट इज।
कैन
Yeah, some, yeah, I think at least 2-3 girls should ask some questions.
Exactly. I think they're annoyed with me because I should not be married.
No, they are very happy. They are the ones that should be
happy.
My question is for you, dear sir. You said that you make stories on subjects that you do not have clarity about, on which you're confused yourself. So when is it that you get your closure? Is it during the writing process or the direction process? And if it's not during the writing process, then how does that affect your writing? Like, if you do not have clarity on what is going to be the end, then how do you sort of bring the end to the story?
Director's block.
Sometimes I don't understand the difference between writing and direction. You know, like technically I do, but I sometimes don't know on the set also whether I'm writing or directing. Yeah, the instruction thing. So even if I put that as one activity, and I appreciate your question, it's a very intelligent question, as beautiful as your kurta is. And I think what happens is that the answer to my question is not the end of the film, or rather the end of the film, which I might come to as a writer, is not the answer to my question sometimes. I have rarely come to an answer to any question while making a film. That question has led me to make that film. That question has led me to create that scene, etc. Sometimes in the engagement, sometimes in the acting, some penny drops. True. But that is not really an answer. It's not really as simple as that. Some things happen. Like, I'll give you an example. I had a recurring dream that I'm missing a dream. Before I made your period. Almost every night, every couple of nights, I used to have this dream that I am running after the train and go to platforms. Now I am running here, then I am in a taxi, I am in a bus, I am in an aircraft. Different people are with me, you know, my friends of that time, they are with me, and somehow I catch the train. After I made Jab Vi Main, in which the girl has this problem. You know, she says, "Mujhe na recurring dream aati hai ki meri train miss ho rahi hai." After I made this film, I realized a couple of months later that I'm not getting that dream anymore. Something addressed. You know, so that's what I mean by questions and answers or engagements. Not directly, but something takes you there, and then you get some sort of thing.
I think his answer deserves a big applause.
Good evening, I'm Sharmila from Kolkata, I'm a journalist. My question to Rahul Ji, you just told, this is an information to me that your credit as a director was not mentioned in Love Story. This is an information because I used to know that you were the director.
Yes.
Similarly, I'd like to tell you, there is a song by Asha Ji, which was actually, we used to know that Usha Uttub has sung it, because Usha Ji has sung this song in every program.
Which
there
song
is a song?
Just hum the first line, no?
That was sung by Asha Ji. That was sung by Asha.
But you love me.
Yeah. No. This has got no connection with love story. My deduction is, do you think that emotion has no copyright? Because if the artist himself believes or herself believes that this song is mine, or that film is mine, or that song picturization could have been mine, he or she can own it.
You cannot have a copyright on an emotion. You cannot say this emotion belongs to me. But what you express that emotion, maybe through a poem or through a song or through a visual, you have the copyright on that.
The artifact, the art, can have a copyright, should have a copyright.
But not the emotion itself.
And I feel much more connected to Sholay or to Arjun than I feel to my own films. Then that doesn't mean that Arjun is my film, huh? So emotionally I'm more connected. So that is not applicable, I think, if that's what you were asking.
Yeah. We never knew that Rahul Rawail is not the director or the copyrighted director of
not the copyrighted.
Okay. Yes. Similarly, Usha ji, whenever he sings the song, he always says that it is my song because I am connected to, my soul is connected to this song.
Okay, that way. So it's just an expression of her love and admiration for that song.
We never ever questioned whether it has belonged to Usha ji in some time.
I think you should take up a last question.
Yeah, sure.
Sir, I wanted to ask a question that how do you select the name of your
How do you select the name?
The title of the film and the name of the film.
I don't know what to say. I only worked with one writer, a veteran writer, called Abrar Ali, when I made the film BBOB. And he's the only writer who told me that he needs a week to decide on the names of the characters. So I said this man has gone berserk.
He needs 1 week.
1 week to decide the names. After a week, when he told me the names he had kept for the characters, he had actually a reason for keeping. He had linked the entire film that I'm keeping this, the protagonist's name Chandar, because in that scene, I will use this dialogue with Chandan. So, you know, he had done it. Otherwise, kya hota hai? Jo naam ko acha lagta hai, rakh dete hai. Usme kaun kuch hua hai?
I feel there is a vibe, you know, there is a certain vibe or a characteristic of a character where a certain name suits that person more or less. Like there is a certain silence to Meera. In my head, like that's how I look at Meera. So therefore Deepika was called Meera in Love Aajkal, where she was called Veronica in the other film, in Cocktail. And Geet was, because she's like, Geet was, it just sounded right. I knew only one girl called Geet before that, Geet Dhillon that too. And then she called many years later saying that, were you like secretly in love with me? She was my senior school. So, yeah, I think there is some sort of a khanak, jisko bolte hai na, ek awaz, ek naam mein khanak hoti hai, ek kashish hoti hai, whose character se match kare to acha lagta.
I think we need to.
I guess, yeah, they're actually
asking us to wrap up. Last
20 seconds, 20 seconds.
Okay. रॉक स्टार यहाँ पे बैठे हुए हैं जिन्होंने रॉक स्टार बनाई यार ड्रीम. मैं सर मैं देखता हूँ रॉक स्टार तो पता नहीं क्या हो जाता है. ये सबूत है सर. सर ये बताइए रॉक स्टार आई कहाँ से दिमाग में.
आते हैं रैप से ही मजामी ख्याल में.
वाह
दिस कम फ्रॉम अ वैक्यूम. ये राजीव कृष्ण की लाइन थी. But you don't know where it comes from. I can say, I can stand up over here and मैं बहुत impressive बात बोल सकता हूँ कि फलाने तारीख को मैं फलाने ट्रेन की जर्नी में जा रहा था ऐसे. कुछ नहीं हुआ तो मुझे भी नहीं पता कि ये कहाँ से आता है. ये कहीं उस किसी नींद की उस करवट से आता है जो मेरे तस्वुर में या मेरे ख्याल में नहीं है. I don't know where it comes from.
Like you said, ki pata nahi kahan se aata hai. I made a film called Arjun. In the climax of Arjun, Anupam Kher, who is the antagonist, is a politician, and elections are going on, and suddenly he is running away with some documents, and he's being chased by the politician people, and he runs into a dead end in Bombay, where there's a huge poster of Anupam Kher. And there's a tiny sunny roll there. He's trapped and the goons come in there, and now Sunny is trapped. And somehow he, without explaining it, because I had to bring him out of the situation, somehow he just manages to get out of that situation. When the review came in Times of India, which Khalid Mohammed wrote, Khalid Mohammed said, the most brilliant portion in Arjun was that one shot, where Sunny is trapped, and this little rat runs across the frame, and seeing that rat, Sunny decides and gets the idea of how to come out of it. Believe me, I have never seen the rat. Okay, I called my assistant and I said, "Tune chua dekha tha kisne?" I said, "Nahi dekha tha." So we went to the theater to see that scene again, and the rat didn't exist, and this man had seen it. So after that, when I was asked in interviews, I said, "Let me capitalize it." They said, "What about this?" I said, "Yeah, you know, I should really think how do I get Sunny out of this." So then I thought of a rat, and I see a rat outside a building running across. So believe me, it was nothing but a plan.
बहुत सब्र से बनती है लाइफ में भी इन जनरल बहुत सब चाहिए होता है कभी कभी गैप से भी बन जाते हैं एंड वी कैन सम अप दिस होल डिस्कशन विद व्हाट हिज लास्ट लाइन ऑफ द शॉर्ट फिल्म वाज टू ड्रीम इज द ओनली आंसर क्वेश्चन में बी व्हाटएवर ड्रीम इज द आंसर